Okay. Picture the scene. You're in your room. You're 15 years old. No, you're not doing that. You want to make a change. But you always feel like you're second-guessing yourself. This change, it has to inspire you. And before you ask, no, I'm not going through a quarter-life crisis. This change is completely organic, and it has nothing to do with the fact that I was dumped for some douche who has a haircut like a rejected boy band member.
Oh, come on, you were 15, get over it.
This emotional pain feels like gut-wrenching pain and your soul's dripping out of you. You can't sleep or eat.
You didn't even get to first base.
And with all this emotional turmoil, what do you do?
Somebody please shoot me in the face.
You feel like you can't go on.
Somebody shoot him in the face.
Shut up, I've got this.
Right, I'll give you one more cheesy cliche and
she was special. But I'll find somebody new. She wasn't everything I wanted.
You were 15, yeah?
Yes.
She had boobs.
Yeah.
How is that not everything you've ever wanted?
So after having my heart broken, smashed into a million pieces and then glued back together and then have the same thing happen again, I changed.
Are you coming out right now?
I wanted to make a change for myself.
Oh, you totally are, I knew it.
I swear, if you interrupt me one more time...
Oh, well, when does it get good?
Well, if you just let me.
Oh,
for goodness sake. Right, when I got dumped, I wanted to figure out a way to get any girl that I wanted, any girl. And to make sure that I'd never get dumped again. Never, ever. And to mess up the social, everything, just everything. And so, I changed.
So what, you wouldn't get dumped anymore then?
Yeah, I'd be out. So I would be the dumpee, right?
You said dump and pee in the same word, I knew you would.
You have to get your priorities straight.
Oh! Look, you met me the first day of Freshers Week and I've been helping you.
Mocking me?
Ever since. A girl will undoubtedly throw herself at you at some point.
The girl's always like that.
Oh, don't be so disgusting, but yeah, we are.
And how do you know?
Do you really want to know the first thing about dating a woman? Bear in mind, the first rule, the most important thing about dating a woman and being able to give her complete and utter satisfaction for years to come. Hang on a second.
certainly didn't expect that to be your response.
You are such an idiot.
I'm your idiot.
What are friends for, yeah?
Yeah. So, what do you want to do now?
I love drama.
Matt! Greg! How are you? How are you, good sir?
Good, how are you? Oh, my goodness.
Hey, do you remember when we used to? You know.
No, I don't remember that. No.
You do, don't you?
Yes.
Well, do you want to?
Only, like, always?
Harmonica. More harmonica, I think. Bassoon?
You're a dick.
Thank you. I've got my 12-sided die, and I'm ready to roll. With a wizard and my goblin crew. My friends are coming over to my mom's basement, bringing Doritos and some Mountain Dew.
I got a big broadsword made out of cardboard, and that stereo's pumping Zeppelin. It's the time of the night we turn on the black light.
Let the dungeons and the dragons begin. It's D&D. Fighting with the legends of yore. It's D&D.
Never kissed a lady before.
Nope. Hey, Matt, play a little guitar.
Play a little guitar.
Yeah, go on. Play
a
little guitar.
Play my little guitar.
Yeah, go.
Okay.
Ah, oh, did you hear that? Now the Lord of the Rings, the Dark Crystal and things. We use these as a reference tool.
And when we put on our cloaks and tell warlock jokes, we were the coolest kids in the school!
We were.
I know.
We really were. Now Matt's a real bastard, but a fair dungeon master. He's got hit points and charisma to lend.
And I rehearse in my room or when I call the dragon's tomb when I'm not out with my girlfriend.
It's D&D! So, what was that?
What?
You have a girlfriend.
Yeah.
You.
Yeah.
Dungeon Master, have a girlfriend.
Yes, I have a girlfriend.
Okay.
I do. I have a girlfriend. I don't have a girlfriend.
It's D&D. Summoning the demons of hell, it's D&D!
When I shift ends up there. Oh, hello.
Well, my medieval brother, there's room here for another. Would you care to take a roll of the die?
Now listen to my words. You guys are total nerds. I'd rather stick that sword in my eye. You're not a warrior strong, and you're scared of a thumb. There's no such thing as a gnome or a sprite.
We put a spell on thee!
You guys are too much for me.
That's not what you said last night, it's D&D! Warriors who terrify, it's D&D! Virgins till the day we one, two, three, four, die!
Did you see those guys?
Leave them alone, they're cute.
Cute? I was thinking of a different word, to be honest.
I think they are, especially the one with the guitar.
Are you serious?
So what if I am? You're my wingman, right?
Yeah, of course.
John?
Yeah?
Never mind.
Thank you. I feel as if I've just been assaulted by a Glee episode.
I feel so abused. I can never unsee that. John, you're very close to my face right now.
Yeah. Here I am.
Steve, John. John.
Who's Steve?
Wrong name. I always remember her face though. No, John.
What the hell am I gonna do for the rest of my first year? I've already slept with all the decent girls in my course, huh?
I'm on your course.
Yeah, but you know, you're like a good guy.
Except that I'm a girl?
What's up? Look, Jamie, could you just piss off and go and hump a leg or whatever it is you do when you're alone?
Wait, what? Am I interrupting something?
Maybe.
Well, that's not an answer, just kind of like I'm not around.
Right, you asked for it. Lily, wait. Seemingly how everybody on stage has clearly lost their shit and we've become Disney's prince and princess.
Gay!
Just listen.
Aging doctor.
Do you hear me? I'm talking to you. Over the water. Over the deep blue ocean. Above the open sky. Oh my. Baby, I'm trying.
Boy, I hear you. My dreams, I hear you whisper across the sea. What do you keep it there? I keep you with me in my heart. You make it easier when I get lonely.
Lucky I'm in love with my best friend. Lucky to have been where I have been. To be coming home again.
You guys! I've always known this would happen, but honestly, John, I love you too, Lily. It just seems just more feminine.
Oh my god. How many more times I am a girl do you not see these
tits for days?
I see those.
Thank you.
shouting.
I didn't shout at all. Why are you talking so loud?
How did you guys make it through that lecture?
Oh, because there wasn't any shouting.
Right!
Oh.
You guys are amateurs!
Oh, Artie, you smell like a brewery!
Oh, you're so sweet, thanks.
Artie, what's in the flask?
Is that what I think it is?
Oh my god, give it to me! Guys,
where have I heard that before?
Oh my god, shut up. Oh, that's the stuff.
Like a river of the sweetest honey.
I think I just burnt a hole in my esophagus.
What the hell is in that?
I call it my hair of the dog concoction.
Reality check.
Did you do it?
No way! He asked me if I like carp. You know, the fish. Who does that?
Maybe he's I'm broke. Maybe it's the only white meat you can afford.
Oh, I'm not asking about that white meat.
So, how was he?
Come on. I predict he's pretty well. This is so embarrassing. Aren't you guys meant to ask me where we went for our third date? Or if I liked the guy?
It was your third date. There's only one thing we want to know about.
Did you roll before you rocked?
All the gear and no idea.
Guys, let's be a little bit more discreet. All right. Did you, or did you not, ride him like a horse? She did.
Karen, what the hell happened?
He dumped me.
Oh, Jesus.
Sasha got laid.
Hey, Sasha, if you worked in a sperm bank, you'd be fired for drinking on the job.
So, did you do it?
No way, man. I didn't mention the carp thing, though.
Ah, Adam, what? You're your own worst enemy. You're basically cock-blocking yourself.
Hang on, give him a break. He's much more sensitive when he's on his period.
Yeah, and if you're not careful, you and Jordan will sync up!
Stop it! Ow, not my hair! Ow!
Man down!
Hey man, this started much more macho.
Yeah.
You know what? Doesn't even matter.
Well, I definitely see that as a missed opportunity. I mean, something's wrong. You would have thought of at least 15 insults by now.
Yeah, well, me and Karen so broke up.
What?
How come?
I thought you went to work and I thought tonight was the big night.
It was.
You've been dating for weeks, and you pulled out before you could even put it in.
And somehow, we're still single when we're that much more compassionate.
We had sex.
I don't understand.
It's quite simple. When a man and woman love each other, they get naked.
Not now, Jordan.
All right.
What happened? Well, we were sort of... You know.
Yeah.
Go on. Focus.
Okay.
No. Well, when we were sort of together, we were just about and. No, guys, I said his sister's name.
Oh, dude.
Rule number one. Come on.
Never, ever.
And we genuinely mean never.
Piss off a woman.
What's she gonna do? Write a diary, go watch The Notebook. So, no, she's gonna get on with a laugh, and I'm gonna be get on with mine, it's all going to be fine.
Six. Six. Six.
you go. No, not you. Pop. So I come home this one day from work and I am really irritated and I am looking for a little bit of sympathy. And my sperm lying on the couch to drink a beer and chill. No, not you. Popping. So I said to him, I said, you pop that gun one more time. So I took the shotgun off the wall and I fired two warning shots.
Tell her!
I think you're having a breakdown.
I think the correct term is having an unstable mental disposition.
She's gone wacky.
How are we seeing the same things here?
Honey, I love you. But my mother always told me, never, ever stick your dick in crazy.
What a lovely sentiment. Somebody, please tell me why everybody is singing.
Have you got something against singing?
I know what this is. Baby, you can still get involved.
See, I really couldn't sing. I can never really sing. Why couldn't you do a
sing?
I have trouble with a
note.
It gets stuck in my
throat.
It's a terrifying.
Sing.
See, I really couldn't tell which note was lower or was
higher.
Which is why I disappear when someone says it's not a
choir.
Hey, when I begin to
squeak,
it's a cross between
shriek
or quiver or
moan.
It's a little like a
croak.
The record player.
Croak.
When it doesn't have it.
Tone.
Now you're thinking, what a crazy
ding-a-ling.
But I really couldn't
sing.
I can never really
sing.
Why couldn't do a
sing?
It seems you've been compelled to express yourselves musically.
And because I love you both very much, I suggest that we never do that again. And we bury this in a deep, deep, dark, dark part of our subconscious minds. Agreed.
I still love you.
Confess,
said, right? That's what she said.
So, when are we going to do it?
If this isn't misinterpretation, I will definitely be needing another interval.
You say it yourself. You could help me with all my problems with women.
And what's your problem?
Women. They seem to gravitate towards the arseholes. And I'm a nice guy. And if I found a girl that was pretty, sexy, flirty, I'd never let her out of my sight. I'd never let her go.
Well, maybe it's because you're too romantic for your own good and you can't see when a girl is completely, totally and utterly into you.
And who the bloody hell would that be then? Would that be your mate, Alex? The female one? Because if it's the male one...
You are probably the most dense person I've ever met. I don't think you'd know who it was if they slapped you in the face.
Well, that'd be much simpler now, wouldn't it?
What are friends for? Finished!
make it better by adding a drum or a guitar solo, okay? It doesn't work like that! And it's...
Lauren? Hey, Dave. Hi. Hey, look, Karen's sister.
Thank you. well, before I get too drunk on this, I've not prepared a speech. I really just want to say that I've never done anything this pretty, obviously, before. I've never done anything to this magnitude, and I'm just immensely proud of every single member for sticking with me and putting up with me when I got really bossy in the last few weeks. Me, bossy.
Who knew?
Stop you guys. No, really, I was evil. So I just want everyone in the audience just to give these guys one huge round of applause, because it could not have been done without them. So not sure if anyone else wants to say any words, but I'd like to mention to any people who want to continue the party, tonight we might be going to Mosh. So if you want to come join us and get very, very parents, if there are parents here, not too drunk.
Very,
but students, if you're here,
extremely wasted.
So thanks very much, guys. Thank you for coming along.